Hello and welcome back to Cryostasis. In the last episode, we wandered around what I presume is a ship and looked back into the lives or the deaths of some of the crewmen that were on board. We actually fought a few zombie-looking creatures and even saved the soul of a man, which brought us to this point. And now we continue by punching icicles. Let's get through this door. Are you not going to open? You opening? No? Where am I going? Oh, there's more than one handle. Do I have to do all of them? Is that them all? I don't know which ones I've done and which ones I haven't. Did I do you? What about these ones at the bottom? Is that all of them? There we go. Check behind us just in case we're getting attacked by more of those zombie creatures. Give these icicles a good seeing to. There you go, get out of my way. I'm looking at my health bar, it's not very big at the moment. Oh! There was a loading screen there, I will cut that out when I come to edit the video. So let's carry on. Get down here. Yeah, I've not got very much health at the moment. Get out of my way. Don't forget to keep warm. Yeah, we already know that. You've already told us. Is there an heat source around here? What about you? Aha. Every time I do this, it seems that my heat bar down in the bottom left there gets a little bit bigger. I keep meaning to keep my eye on it to see if we gradually lose heat over time. And it looks as though we do. Oh, are you gonna come and try and kick my ass now? So are these actually zombies? Oh no. Don't you be doing that. So these attacked the crew as well. So whatever it is, it broke out on the ship. Did that lead to the ship sinking or crashing into the ice? Why is this water not frozen? Oh, probably because of the fire over there. What do you do? Oh, is that a new weapon? Let me over here to this fire, I need to get warm. There we go. I do wonder what he actually does with his weapon while he's warming his hands up, because he don't seem to crouch down to pick it back up again. That's the way we came in. Where are you? There you are. Don't you be running away. Get back here. Yeah. Arsehole. Has this gone out? Can I use it again? Top up on health. Don't seem to be doing anything to our health, though, actually. No. It's not going up at all. I'm noticing a few stutters in the frame rate. I'm not sure if that's just because it's quite an old game and it's not very optimised or not. But things like these are making me jump around a lot. Right, let's get through here. Get out of my way. Right, I presume something's going to attack me. No. What's falling? Get out of my way. Oh dear. Let's not go in the water. Don't think that'll end very well. Oh, there you are. You dead? Any more of yous? No. Where am I going? Can I get up here? No. Some further in then. Ah, round there. And up here. I could do with a fire. Now, can we save this man's soul? Is that what these red glowing bits on them mean? Oh! Yeah, let's not go in the water. Okay, so I'm back in that area now. Let's try not to go for a swim this time. How exactly am I supposed to get to you? Let's get rid of this ice first. Now, it looks to me as though the only way that I can go is onto these pipes here. So I'm going to attempt to do that, and hopefully that doesn't get me killed. So am I looking for a lifeboat? Is that it? Oh! Am I controlling this or is it going on its own? No, it's going on its own. What's going to jump out on me? The torch is following my line of sight though. Yeah, I'm pretty sure somebody's going to jump out on me in a minute. That's usually the way. Yep. Go on, where was that? Where are you? Up there. Stop that! Yep. Bastard. Get down here. Kick your ass. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Have some. Have some. Have some. Have some. Yeah, go on. Get down there. I showed you. How many more of you are there? Come on, barrel, get out of my way. Ah, yes, I see ya. Trying to sneak up on me. Ah, I see you there as well. And there. Get out of it. How many times are you going to keep coming back? This has got to be the slowest boat in existence. Oh. What's happening? Have we done it? So that's where he came to in the boat. Oh, there's something on that boat. Do we need to use this boat now? Should imagine so. What are you? Or who are you?
Danko was one of them. And he was young and handsome. Handsome people are always courageous. And he said to his comrades, "Stones are not to be removed by thinking. He who does naught will come to naught. Why should we exhaust our energies thinking and brooding? Arise, let us go through the forest until we come out at the other end. After all, it must have an end. Everything has an end. Come, let us set forth." They looked at him and saw that he was the best man among them, for his eyes were aglow with life and strength. "Lead us," they said, and he led them.
Yeah, so I'm actually not sure what the narrator's going on about there. It almost sounds as though she's talking about godly-like people. I'm sure it'll become clear in time. Nope. Up, up, up. Yeah, that's the way I want you to go. Right, who's waiting for us behind this door then? You're not gonna... Oh, there we go. So what's this, the commander's office?
Captain, a difficult stretch ahead. Should we go around?
A difficult stretch, you say? We'll manage. We can't afford to lose a whole day.
We might lose a lot more if it's as bad as it looks.
My crew has been through a lot worse than that. And they can certainly manage that little patch of ice.
But, sir, isn't it better to avoid difficulties altogether if we can?
Are you suggesting I shouldn't have faith in my crew?
It's not about trust, sir. It's about common sense.
And do you think it makes common sense to navigate the Arctic for 20 years in a row?
Can't you see there is real danger up ahead?
Are you losing your courage? Have you been testing your rod again? Don't you know it's not the rod, it's the dowser? Just go to your cabin. You'll be safe there.
This is insane.
So the captain doesn't seem overly fond of him. There we go. Top up on health. This shovel, can I take it? No. Right. So that's the way I came in. Turn the flashlight on. There's a door here. But we can't go through. Oh, yeah, I can. Can I? No, I can't go through that one. That looks like a dead end. Oh no, this is a dead end. So we must have to go down this way. Where are you? Down there. What did that light ever do to you? And how long is it going to take you to get up here and try and attack me? Oi! Open, bastard. Come on, I know you're around here somewhere. Get out of my bloody way. Stupid icicles. Let's get us some power. Oh, there you are. Oh, what's that? Get back here. Oi! Where are you going? Where is it? Where did he go? I can't get through there. What did he throw? Come down here. That looks dangerous. Could cause an injury, that. You'd have health and safety all over you. Oh, wrong button, sorry. Really? Which way am I going? Well, I presume I did that wrong. Let's try that again. Maybe it's not a good idea to open the door. Well, maybe I just needed to lock that first. Stop the water coming through. I'm still not convinced I'm doing the right thing. Oh no, I was right. Okay. So does that mean that we saved his soul? Goddamn ice getting in my way everywhere. I want that shovel. Surely it'd be better to hit zombie things with than this bloody valve thing. Could do with you being on. No, can't get through there. Aha! What are you?
A divining rod. A stick. It doesn't matter what kind, it's immaterial. What matters is you. You just need to tell yourself to find water. Send this thought to the rod, and that's it. It works best when you can wander around fields and forests by yourself, letting your senses take over. But when you're followed by a crowd, finding water can be difficult. For this reason, many expert dowsers search for water secretly, at odd hours, in order to get the privacy they need.
Okay. I shall go water dousing tomorrow morning, 3 o'clock in the morning. I shall do it in the middle of nowhere and make sure that no one's watching. Because I'm in desperate need of water. I also appear to be waffling quite a lot of crap. Right. Can't get through there at all. Oh, it was up here that I went, wasn't it? Can I get through this door now? Is the light on? No. Okay, let's see what this button does. Brings down that ladder then. I really could do with some health right about now. I need a light source or something. So how long until something jumps out on me again, do you think? There's another ladder over there. Can I use that light? No, I can't. Is there a light at all? What's this control panel over here? Ah, that turns the lights on. Ah, there we go. Health. Finally. Right, where are you? There you are. Get down. Really intrigued as to what actually happened on this ship. I've started to auto-save a little bit more often.
Check it out! Will the cables hold?
Yeah, it's alright. We almost got it up. Come on, just a little more.
Wait, the stopper keeps sliding off.
Yeah, I knew he was going to be right there then. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Get a beat down. Give me some health. Yeah, I started to auto-save a bit more often. When I died earlier by falling into the water, it actually took me quite far back, so I'd rather not have to go through all that again if I do die in future. Oh, that's a shame for you. Oh, hello. You are one ugly piece of crap. Right, let's see what this guy has got to say. Oh, I suppose. Oh, you've got an actual head in your hood. Where are you going with that?
Damn it, this sucks. This one is empty as well. Everything I got out of the others I put into the diving suit. There is enough oxygen for about 5 minutes. All right, we've got what we've got. Hope it's enough. Go to the elevator, I'm sending it down.
Is this the elevator? Where's the elevator? Oh yeah, that was the elevator. Right. Let's get around there. Are you sending me underwater? Do you know how cold that water is? I've got an oxygen meter now in the left-hand corner.
Be careful when getting out of the elevator. The water is real murky. Turn left immediately and look for me. I'll be in the boat.
Turn left immediately. Well, this is about as fast as I can go. Can't actually move any faster.
You were on the upper decks back then, and we're all down here. So we're just sitting here, minding our own business, and then, holy, the water just, wham, came pouring in.
Well, that's a shame for you. Oh, go away. Oi!
Wait up! I'll lower the gates. All of it. Rivets, bolts, screws, everything. Rags. I mean, you know, the sides ripped along the seams like tissue paper. That was one hell of an impact. But we dealt with it, thank God. Got some padding, patched up the walls, made some struts, and then, you know the rest. First, it got hot. Then it got cold. Now it's weird. All the diving.
So he seems to be shedding a little bit of light on what actually happened. But it's interesting that he says it got hot before it got cold.
Hey, what's happening out there? Watch out! There's a lot of junk at the bottom.
There's also a dead dude swimming around. Well, I presume he's dead. What are you doing to that pole? You filthy, filthy, filthy person. I hope you got that Paul's consent.
Yo, come on! Watch out! It's barely holding together! Yeah, I know it's murky as hell, I know! Come on, you're almost there!
We have got to be the slowest person in existence.
There are some rusty pipes there with some valves on them. I got some circulation going here so it doesn't freeze up. And listen, you watch your step. Don't touch those valves. The pipes won't hold. Hey, why am I telling you? You know that already. It's been like that for years.
Don't touch the pipes. Don't touch the pipes. Oh, do one.
That's done it. The frigging pipes. That's it. Now, if we don't drain them, they'll all be frozen solid by tomorrow. Yeah, yeah, enough with the talking. You're almost there. Get through the gate. Come on.
I'm going. You don't happen to know that I'm being attacked by a frigging swimming zombie fish man thing. And you try rushing around when you move as slow as this. I've been in that boat. That thing was slow and it's moving
go
faster than me.
Go to the side and then make a right. I'll head to the winch. We'll go from there.
Go to the side and then make
there
a right.
There should be a piece of wood there. We used it and some padding to plug the hole. I'll lower the support strut, and you cut the lines with your blowtorch. Lowering!
Where? Oh. Cut the lines with my blowtorch.
Cut the lines on both hooks on the sides.
Yeah, I'm trying to. Caught, you damn bugger.
Good.
There's one. And this one. Come on. Caught.
Okay, It's in place. I'm turning the engine on now. You watch the stopper.
What stopper?
First stage complete.
How much more of this is there? Okay, so we did a little bit of diving. And this seems like a good place to end off this episode. I am going to end it off here. Please let me know your thoughts in the comments below, whether that be positive or negative. And I will always take everything you say into consideration. I will see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.